Morning. It's cold outside. I'm much too lazy to go out in the shop today. So, I want to make a video, and I'm actually going to make it in two parts. First part is going to be today in the house, obviously, at the computer. So, here's the thing. I can't afford to buy walnut and maple and mahogany and all this stuff all the time. And I can't even find it half the time. So I have to revert to things like pine and poplar and oak, because that's all that Lowe's and Home Depot carry, and that's all I got around here. So I tend to make things out of plywood a lot, because you can find maple and birch plywood. You can't find walnut plywood, but that'd be awesome. So I wanted to do a project today that I could use plywood. And maybe it'll turn out okay, maybe it won't, but we'll find out. So what are we gonna do? We're gonna make a game. Anybody heard of Wahoo? That's what we're gonna make. So let me show you a Wahoo board real quick. This is a Wahoo board. I'm sure y'all played this sometime. And basically this is just a cheap compressed cardboard. It's old. There's nothing wrong with it. It works. We play it all the time. But I think it needs to be redone, and it needs to be a little bit heavier, a little bit better built, and I want my own spin on it. And basically, the layout's gonna stay the same. Little design change here and there, but the same number of holes, the same number of these, all that good stuff, that's gonna remain the same. So basically, that's Wahoo. So what I'm gonna do is, I'm gonna get into the computer and we're gonna get to designing this thing. And tomorrow maybe we'll get out in the shop and we'll actually make it, and you'll see where I'm going with it. But for today, we're just gonna design it on a computer. So let's go. Alright guys, so here we are in VCarve Pro. So first thing we're going to do like usual is start to create a new file. For this project we're going to be doing 14 inches by 14 inches square. That's the size of the board that we have already. We're going to set it to 0.75 inches thick. It's going to be single sided material surface for our Z0, and okay. Alright, so first thing I think we need to do is lay out the holes. If you remember the board that I showed you earlier, there were several holes. I've done a rough measurement, and I think the way that I want to do it is to go with the copy array. So bear with me. First thing we need to do is create our circle. I've already measured the diameter of the holes in there that'll fit marbles, and it is 0.440. So we're going to go diameter 440, and we're going to create one. All right, so now that we've got our hole, there's our hole. Now we can actually do our copy array, or array copy. So let's open this up, and now we need to decide how many rows and columns. Well, since this is a 14 by 14 square, it's going to be the same on both the rows and the columns. And we're going to try this out with 15 and 15. I'm not sure if it's going to work, but we'll find out. The gap on the X, I think 1 inch apart is going to be just about perfect. And all we can do is copy it and see what happens. So here we go. Now let's go ahead and center it. Oh, wow. Yeah, that's nowhere even near close. Not even close. What did we do wrong here? Let me take a measurement here. And is that an inch? Okay, I want an inch from center to center. So let's go back and we'll do that again. And we'll change. Well, we need to reselect the circle. Then click on that. It automatically puts our value in there. Let's change this to 0.5, 0.5, and see what happens. Now let's center that again and see how it looks. All right, now that looks a little bit better. However, it is still not quite right because when I look at the board, I'm seeing that the holes are a little bit closer than they should be. So let's back out of this again and we'll try it one more time. We've already got that selected. And now keep in mind something here. I'm not editing this video at all. I want y'all to see what, for the new guys that, you know, don't really know much about the program or you know, how to design things, you know, what I go through when I design something and how long it actually takes in real life. Hopefully this video is not 2 hours long, but yeah, it may be. All right, so let's get back in here. And the only thing I'm going to change is I'm going to take this down to 1414. Okay, let's center this off. And you know what? Now that looks good. I think that should be okay. Now when I look at the board, it has, I wish I had a picture. I might throw a picture up right now if I can. I just have to remember to do it. But you know, each end of the home, like near the goal part, has five holes. So like there's five holes right here, and then five holes here this way. And so that's what I'm going by to figure out if I'm, you know, got enough room here. So you'll see what I'm talking about here in a minute. All right, so this should be the direct center from here to here, and it should be, well, let's see. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So now I don't have a direct center here. That's not going to work. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Yeah, that's not going to work. Okay, back to the drawing board. All right, we'll get this right. We're going to have to go 15, but we're going to have to change the size up a little bit. All right, so 15, 15. And instead of a half inch, we're going to do it 0.4 and 0.4. Copy. See how this looks. All right, that's gonna have to work, I think. All right, so then our dead center one should be, let's see. Yeah, what you can't see is I got my finger on the screen up on this one going da da da, trying to find the one in the exact center just to make sure. Why don't we have one in the center? I don't understand. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. So I should get 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Yeah, right there. That's the center. Okay. All right. So that should be the same all around. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 on the eighth. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. All right. I made that more complicated than it needed to be. All right. So what we got is I'm holding down the shift key so I can highlight these. Five. That's our home run there. And when I look at the board, I got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 going up. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And then I should go all the way down. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. We should be able to go around this whole thing and copy the layout of the Wahoo board just like so. 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Yeah, I'm sorry if this is annoying you guys, but hey, this is how I do it. And all right, so what I want to do is I'm gonna group those. Okay, so those are all in a group. Now what I want to do is, if you can't see that, see these are highlighted, these aren't, it's because they're grouped. So if I click on that, okay, you guys get the picture. All right, so now what I need to do is I need the holes in the goal, the home area, and there's a total of five from here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So what I'll do is I'll hold the shift key down. That's 4, that's 5, and we'll do that to the rest. 2, 3, 4, 5, two, three, four, five. Two, three, four, five. And we'll group that. So we're going to add those in. Now you can see they're all part of the same group. Okay, it might be hard to see. Now what we need is we need four, one, two, three, four, for our home starting point in each corner. One, two, three, four. One, two, three, four. One, two, three, four. And one, two, three, four. That doesn't look right, does it? Nope. You know why? Because I did the wrong one. All right, one, two, three, four. All right, now we're good. So, got our four diagonals in each one. We're gonna go ahead and click group again, group all that together. All right, so now we have got all our holes except for the one in the middle. We need the middle. All right, so this is our dead center. We'll group that one as well. All right, so now what I'm gonna do is, I'm gonna highlight every single one of these and make sure that everything is, see, now this right here is still dotted, so that one's not grouped with all the others. So we need to fix that. So we're gonna highlight all the ones that are grouped. We're gonna hold shift down and highlight that one little errant one there, and we're gonna group that with it. All right, now let's check and make sure we got everything. All right, we're looking, making sure all of our solid line circles are where they need to be. All the dotted ones are the ones we're fixing to delete. And what we're gonna do is we're gonna hold down shift, deselect those, and hit delete, and there's your game board. Perfect. All right, so we've got our game board, but we have a problem. I have a problem. I think this needs to be scooted over here. It is way too close. So let's go back to this whole grid real quick. Oh, nope. Because this kind of lets you see what you got. And if you can tell, there's no way to move this back. Maybe we can. Let's try something real quick. I'm wondering if I can just 1, 2, 3, 4, and that'll, yeah, I think that's what I'm gonna do. I think I need to skip this one. I think that might look better. Let's try it. So what we're gonna do here is see, how do I wanna do this? All right, I'll tell you what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna actually, how to do this. All right, I'm gonna highlight that, and then every one in the corner, I'm gonna highlight, and I'm gonna add it to that group. Then I'm gonna go back in here, highlight everything, deselect that, delete, and these are the ones right here that I don't want. So I'm gonna ungroup everything. Okay, let me try that again. I'm gonna ungroup everything. I'm going to ungroup everything. Hold down the shift key and delete those, and that looks a lot better, I think. So that's what we're gonna do. Go back in and group everything back together. All right, so there's our board layout. Excellent. So now what we're gonna need to do is we're gonna need to figure out our lines. You know, how do we, now it's the fun part. Now we get to start designing and putting lines and whatnot. And really there's no right or wrong way to do this. You just have to kind of do whatever you feel like you want to do. So I might actually fast forward this part, but you know what? How much time we got on there? Screw it. We'll just do the whole thing. All right. So what we can do here is we can actually, we can import some images, we can V-carve some stuff in there. Remember, we're working with plywood, so we're not going to be doing any 3D carving. We can put some lines, we can put some words, we can do all sorts of things. I don't really know what we're going to do. So what I'm actually going to do is, for the sake of not showing a bunch of personal information and whatnot on here, I'm going to pause the video and I'm going to go download some images and look at it. And when I come back, we'll start putting them in there. Okay, so let's get back at this. I went and looked online for some images, thought maybe I'd put some real fancy decorative things in there and whatnot, and then I totally decided against it. In the end, I decided what I wanted to do was keep it fairly simple. So what I need to do first is I need to put some outlines and borders around all these things, and I've been racking my brain trying to figure out a good way to do that. And I have a very chaotic way of doing things, so you'll just have to bear with me, but here's how I decided to do it. I'm going to take my measure tool, and I want to measure the distance from the outside of, the outside of that to the outside of that, and that gives me 12.2 inches. All right, so what I want to do is I need to think how far offset from the edge of the circle do I want this borderline going. And I think about maybe an eighth of an inch would be good. So I'm gonna do this. I want a square that is 8 inch off. So if it's 12.2, then that means it needs to be 12.325? Let's see if that works. No, that's not far enough. Let's try 12.5. I probably miscalculated that, but that's all right. Is that better? Let's see. And how much distance that gives me. And then this is important because, see, that's 0.15 inches. So, you know what? Let's just make it a little further. So let's double click that, go back here and make it 12.75. Apply. All right. Okay. So I think that's good. Now what I need to do is figure out what my distance is. It's 0.275 inches. All right. So what I've done to myself here is I've made it to where the lines that go this way need to be 0.275 inches that far and that far and everything else. So let's see if we can do that. So how are we gonna do this? All right, from here to here is 3.8. So let's see, 3.8 plus 0.275 plus 0.275 is 4.35. So if I do another one of these, it's 4.35 by, let's see, 13. Then that'll give me my pieces going that way. And then I can just take this little tool right here and clip. And nope, not ready to clip that. Okay, so I need to do another one. Here my dog's walking around. Same thing, create, and all we need to do is to, turn it 90 degrees, apply, there we go, close. Okay, now I can get my little vector cut tool and I can start trimming the pieces I don't want. All right, so I'm not gonna want these in the middle. And I'm not gonna want that one. And actually, I'm not gonna end up wanting these either. So there we go. now I've got an outer border for that whole entire thing. And as you saw, like I said, it was a fairly chaotic way to do it, but it works, and everything in there is perfect. So you can do it however you find that's easiest for you. And this is just what worked for me. So now we got these. I want to put some borders around these, but as you can see, we're at an angle. So how do we do that? Well, once again, I'm gonna go to my measure tool and figure out what our distance is. So it looks like we're, 4 inches. Okay, close enough. So 4 inches, let's do a rectangle at, I tell you what, I don't think I like that. I tell you what I want to do. Let's see. These were at, well, I'm going to ungroup all those first. These were at 0.440, if I'm not mistaken. Let's see. 0.44. Okay. I actually just want to put a ring around each one of these. So let's see. 0.5. And if I were to carve on that, no, it's not going to be big enough. So let's see, 0.750. Yeah, there we go. All right, so we'll do 750. Delete that one. And you see that ring around there, right? And you'll see what I'm going to do here in a minute. Now I need to see if there's a quick way to do this. 0.75. Plot. Nope. Great. Here we go. Create. Oh, I think it recreated right on top of that one. That's all right. We should be able to snap too. Boom. All right. Let's see. Create. I bet you it. Snap two. All right. So we're going to do that for all of these. And we're just going to, Oh, we're not getting any snap to feature here. I wonder why not. Well, let's see. Copy, paste. Okay, and to all you that say, well, why don't you just use a Control V? Okay, fine. All right, Control V. Boom. Control V. Boom. All right, come down here, copy, paste. Why did I do that? That's stupid. We need to make a new one. Create, where'd it go? Hang on. Let's see what happens here. Oh, yeah. Having trouble. There we go. Okay. Oh, hey, you know what? Hey, there we go. Why didn't I think about that? You just keep hitting the button and keeps making them. Ah, hang on. If I don't move this out of the way, it thinks I'm wanting to snap to that, I think. Well, see, now there it won't center. Well, here's what you can do. Click on this. No. Click on this. Nope. Click on that. Then click on that. Up here. Center. You use the align to selection. You have to watch out which order you click them in, because if you clicked on the large one first and then the small one, it would have offset it. But let's see if this will snap too now. There we go. Yeah, I have no idea why it didn't before, but alright. See, that one doesn't want to snap too either. Okay, so our selection is this, our sub-selection is this. Nope, see, the little one moved. We didn't want it to move. All right, so we click that. Isn't that what I just did? Yeah, that's what I just did. I don't want to do that. Oh, crap. Let's try this. Does that look right? Is that centered? Yeah, that looks right. Okay. Let's do this. Where did it go? Where is it? It's over here. I don't know why it puts that over there. I don't want it over there. I want it right here. Oh my gosh. I am having so much trouble here. This is the frustrating part about some of this stuff is just why does it do the things it does? You don't really have a choice. You just have to go with it. All right. I'm just going to do it the way I know how. Control V. Move it. Control V. Move it. Control V. Move it. See? I mean, that may not have been the best way to go about it, but it surely worked better than the other ways I was trying. So now we got these rings around them, and like I said, you'll see what those are for here in a minute. All right, now we're going to put one. Nope, we're not. I think I want a square box and a ring around that. I think I want that pocket carved. All right, so in the middle here, we're going to go with, I'm just doing this from the head. Hang on. We're going to go with 1 inch. All right. And everything's lined up, so that should align right to the middle. Perfect. Oh, dogs are barking. Somebody must be home. All right, now I'm going to do a square. And I think that looks, maybe it's about 2.5. Oh, caps lock ain't going to do nothing. Let's see what that looks like. Perfect. But you know what, though? I want a radius external. So my bit will fit in there and it looks nice. All right, so we'll delete that one in the back. And that's gonna be our center ring. That's our little on the mountain ring type thing there. You'll see what that is here in a minute. All right, so now we've got the center. We've got all of our start points. Now I want some arrows, and I've downloaded some, and I need 4 of them. So this will show you where you start when your piece comes, when your marble, when you roll the number and your marble comes out. But first thing we need to do is take this arrow that I've downloaded and turn it into a bitmap, trace it. So we open it. Now we're going to click on the bird. And I always just like to hit preview and see what it looks like without doing any adjustments. Now this doesn't have to be perfect. I don't want it to be perfect. I want it to be kind of different. Just looking at it. Now you can adjust all these and preview, and you can see different things. In this, it doesn't really matter, I don't think. So you know what? I'm just going to apply it, close this, and delete that. So that's what our arrow is going to look like. Now we need to get it vertical the best we can. Move it. And we need to resize that just a little bit. So we just need to put it where we want it. And I think that's where I want it. That's going to indicate that your marble goes there, and that's your start point. And you know, we could write start on there, we could put a word on there, we could just use this arrow, make it a little smaller. You know, you really just have to play around with it and figure out how you want to do it. You know what, matter of fact, I think I'm going to do it this way instead. This is how the original board has it, like this. And then the word start. So let's pick a font. And this is I just built this computer, so I don't have any cool fonts in here. All my old fonts are on my other computer. I just need to find one that I think looks kind of neat, would match the game. And I'm going to end up picking one whether it looks good or not here in a minute, because what usually happens is I end up spending an hour looking at fonts, trying to figure out which one to use. But so this video is not 6 hours long. I'm just gonna I'm gonna pick that one. Start. Alright. And now let's move it over here. Perfect. So there we go. Start. Looks like everything okay. Not everything fits. You can see these kind of touching each other a little bit. We don't want that. So click on that. We're going to convert curves. We'll click on the T. Use the arrow key. Move it out a little bit. Does that need to be spaced? Does that look funny? Maybe it looks a little funny. Maybe we'll move it a little closer. How about that? I think that looks good. All right, we'll get back in there and we'll group that back together. All right, so we got the arrow and the start. And each one of these is going to be color-coded to whatever you decide to do with this. You know, each one is going to have its own color. And that's going to indicate the start's here and you move that way. So we can highlight that. We can group that together. Then we can make that a little smaller, I think. And I think we'd want it like right there. All right. Now we need one of those for each one. So I'm actually looking over at this Wahoo board that's sitting next to me to figure out where these need to go. Okay. So we're going to copy that. We're going to paste. We're going to bring that over here. And it's going to have to be flip. You know what? Why am I doing that? Why don't I just use this thing right here and flip it 90 until I get it where it needs to be exactly. Perfect. Yeah, just like that. Yeah, there we go. And then, so the next guy starts right there. And then we'll just keep doing that. And we'll paste and we'll move him over here. And then we'll come over here and we'll do 90. And we'll get those positioned where we want them here in just a second. So where does this guy start? Here? Yeah. Apply. All right, close that and we'll move him up. Ah, we'll select it and we'll move him up anyway. Okay, now before I get, all right, we gotta decide where we want this. I think right on the edge is where I want it, right to where these line up kinda, you know. Matter of fact, to make it perfect, we're gonna use these grid lines. Put the line right there. Put the line right on the line, and then we take that and move it back. Okay, and we're gonna do that with every one of these. So we'll pull another grid line out here, move that till it touches. Perfect. Same thing here. Take a grid line, pull it down, move that back. Tap, tap, tap. Perfect. And we got one more. Well, we got this guy. So we'll pull a grid over here. And that's already right on the dot. Okay. So what I want to do real quick is I want to see what these look like carved. So we're shift and we're going to hold these down. We're going to come up to tool path. We're going to V-carve using a 30 degree bit. 70 and 70. Okay. Sounds good to me. We'll calculate that. Reset this preview. Preview all our toolpaths. Oh boy. You know what? I should have deleted that earlier. I was playing around off camera. Yeah. Alright. Now let's preview all toolpaths. Alright. So this is what our start and our arrow is going to look like. And I think that looks good. I think that looks good. Hopefully it'll carve deep enough to where when I fill it in with paint, it'll actually stay in there when I sand over it. But I think that looks good, so we're going to leave that the way it is. The one thing I want to do is to remove these grid lines real quick, and I want to make sure that our distances are good. So we'll measure from the bottom of the tee to the edge of the board, get that straight as we can. It's like 0.3331, and this is just me being me. See, that needs to be moved out some. It's too close. See, that's still. See, well, let me move it. Man alive. How am I going to get that exactly 0.3331? I think I'm just going to have to pretend that it is 0.3509. Let's try it again. I find it kind of hard to have 0.3409. All right, move it in one more time. Oh yeah. I find it hard to actually talk while I'm doing this because I gotta concentrate on what I'm doing or I lose my train of thought. 3309, perfect. Now let's see if let's see how we do this one here. I think that looks a little close. Okay, we're gonna see how close we get here. 0.297. All right, we need to go 1, 2, 3. Try. And there's 0.31. Man, we still need to keep going. There's probably a tool in here that I can use. I just, tell it exactly how far away from that line I want it. It'll probably just shoot it over there. But you know what? That one's like 1 millionth away. I don't care. It's close enough. Nobody will be able to tell. 0.39. Okay, that's a little far. I think that's probably it right there. Bottom of the tee. Or one more. Oh God, I can't help it. I gotta measure that. Nope. All right, that's it right there. All right, so now we got our starts and they're all as close as I'm ever gonna get them. So now we need to put the word Wahoo in here because by golly, it just needs it. So let's see here. Let's see how that looks in all caps. Does that look good? Got some touching going on here. I don't like that. But you know what though? No, I don't like that. I want everything connected. I just don't think I'm gonna get it with, we'll see how that works. Nope, don't like that either. You're probably gonna have to sit here and watch me look at fonts for an hour. Oh, I hate this part. Well, what about that one? You know what I just had? Yeah, it is. Okay. We're going to use it. All right, we'll convert it to curves. We need to move some of this stuff. Just can't have them touching. So that should be good right there. Let's move it over here. Now, if you notice these little snap to grids, these are pretty nice. That means it's right in the middle. Now you just need to figure out where you want it. That looks good. Right there. Now we need to copy, paste, flip that sucker 90 degrees. Move it over here. Get it right in the middle. Right there. You think that's too much? I think that might be too much. Put Wahoo all over the place. I think that actually might not look too good. Nope, I don't like it. I don't like it. Okay, I don't like that. But I want it to say Wahoo somewhere. I just don't know where. Maybe not. Okay. Yeah, we're just not. All right, so you know what? I mean, I hate to say it, but I think that might be about it. Simple might be better in this case. Maybe in here we'll put the word goal so it corresponds with a color. Yeah, we'll do that. We'll do that. Each one will have the word goal. But it's going to be in a regular font. I don't want any crazy cursive. So we'll pick a... What about Georgia? Do I have Georgia? I like Georgia. Goal. All right, perfect. Goal. Copy. Paste. Oh, move them over here. Paste. Move that one over here. Paste. Move that one over here. Okay, now we need to get to flipping these. All right. No. 90 degrees, apply. Keep flipping it. There we go. And then it automatically kind of knows it. You kind of knows you want it in the center there. And we're actually going to have to, no, we're going to flip that one too. Yeah, you may think that's upside down, but it's really not. That's automatically where it went, so it's kind of saying that, is that really in the center? Does that look centered? Ah. There we go. All right. We're going to stretch these. Matter of fact, so that we get it perfect, I want to bring these down. And I want to put these grid lines on each of these because I want this stretched exactly from grid line, just like that. But before we can do that, let's go back to before we stretched it. We need to convert it to curves. We're gonna have to do this with every single one of them because we didn't do it beforehand. Move it away. And then we're gonna have to regroup it. And now we can stretch it. And all the dimensions will stay the same. So, just like that. But that doesn't look like it's centered in between here, so let's see. Does that look centered? That looks centered. All right. So now I'm gonna redo all the work I did. Oh man, this is what I love about doing this. And you know, this is just like I said, you know, this is me doing it live. This is what I would do if I was designing anything else. We're gonna copy and then we'll control V. Oh, that control V. I hit control X, so I don't know what I just did. And then we're gonna flip that sucker 90 degrees. Just like that. Okay. Control V. Put that one there. Flip it 90 degrees. Okay. And actually we need to get our grid lines over there. So we can make sure it's right where we want it. Why is that not stretched? Oh, that's because I put the grid line in the wrong place. grid line goes there. And then it's good. All right. So that one's good, that one's good, that one's good. We need one more. Control V. We need to put that one over here. And let's flip her around 90 degrees. Is that the right direction? It is. All right, now we need to... move it to the middle. Does that look like it's in the middle? Eyeball. Good. Okay. Let's get rid of all these grid lines that kind of get in the way now. Move. Move. Okay. Now we got all that. I think that's going to be all I want to do. I don't want any more lines or borders or anything else. I think if I put more on there, it's going to distract. So let's go over here and get rid of this. And let's go ahead and highlight all of these. These are going to be our VCarve toolpath. So we're highlighting all those. We're going to select our VCarve. We're going to use a 30 degree bit. We're going to see how this looks. Hopefully 30 degrees isn't too deep. All right. Let's material color. That way we can get in there and see how deep this is. I mean, that's got some depth to it, but I don't think it's going to blow out the center of these letters. Remember, this is plywood. You have to be mindful that, you know, if this was a very small area, it would probably blow this out if you used a larger bit, maybe. But I think we'll be good with that 30 degree bit. So I think that's what we're going to use. You can always, you can click on these different views right here and you look at it from the side. And if you click on the toolpath, you can see how deep it's going to be. And that's actually, man, this is 3/4 inch, so I'd say that's going in about 1/3 of the way, maybe. What do you think? That's pretty deep. But I think we're going to do it anyway. I like those 30 degree bits. I think they work good. All right. All right, so then we've got to decide what we're going to do with all of these. Oh, and before we forget, let's rename this. Start arrow. Start 30 degree. This is just how I do my toolpath naming. All right, then we're going to want all of these borders and outer circles and whatnot. We're going to want to... shift and select every single one of them. And you know, I forgot to do something. Nope. All right. It is all one piece. Good. So those are all my borders. And what I'm going to do with this is I'm going to do a profile, and we're going to do on the line. We're going to go 0.125 inches deep, and we're going to use a 60 degree V bit. We're going to do this 75 and 50. Okay, let's calculate that. Well, let's bring this back up to the top here. Reset our preview and preview that. And then let's preview the other one with it. Preview all toolpaths. How about that? So there we go. All right. Now, what we need to do is figure out how deep we want the holes to be in the middle here, and hopefully that's not too wide of a profile. It doesn't interfere with the hole. So let's get back to our drawing view here. And, I need to figure out how deep I want this hole. So I got my calipers in my hand, and I'm just going to measure the thickness of this board here that we've been using. 0.198. I think I think .25. I think a quarter inch deep is good. I think it's going to be good. All right. So all these, I don't know why I thought we had these all grouped together, but I guess not. So we're going to click all these again. And we're going to group them all back together. And I'm going to leave this one alone. You'll see why. Group all those. Okay. So all these are going to be, let me rename this first. This is going to be borders 60 degree. Oh. All right. So no one knows what that is. Now we're going to do these. These are going to be pockets. So we're going to do a pocket toolpath. So we're going to 0.2250. We're going to use an eighth inch. Why don't we just use a quarter inch? We'll use a quarter inch end mill. Let's see. We'll do that 80 and 70. You know what? We'll try 50. That's probably too slow, but who cares? Calculate. All right. Preview all toolpaths. Boom. So there we go. That is what it's going to look like. All right. So the point is now when I fill this with color, this will be filled with color. The inside will be filled with color, and you'll just be left with this. This kind of cool looking. It looks like a volcano. It just gives you some depth, you know. And if your marble rolls off here, maybe it'll stop in that channel instead of rolling off. But this is going to be framed anyway, so. But you see the point here. Let's actually fill that with a color and. So you're seeing some color there. Yeah, it looks kind of cool. I mean, it doesn't have anything super fancy in it, but you know, sometimes less is more. And in this case, I think that's actually pretty nice. But now we got to get the center part. So I know I'm doing this separately. I probably should have done it with everything else, but I don't care. That's just my crazy way of doing things. Rename. This is marble holes 0.25 because our end mill's a quarter inch end mill, and we can just, you know, we can do this one with the other one. We're gonna pocket that. Same thing, 0.25. All right. I don't know why I didn't do that earlier, but you know what? Center pocket 0.25. We'll group that with the other ones. It'll cut at the same time. Now let's go ahead and view that. Preview all toolpaths. All right, and my center one. Now we need to pocket. I want this pocketed. All right. Oops. I guess control won't do nothing. Shift. And let's do this pocket here. I want it 0.125 deep, and we're going to use a quarter inch, and we're going to do one pass, and we're going to do offset, and let's just see how that looks. Reset the preview. We'll preview all toolpaths. And there you go. That's our board. That's kind of how I want it to look, real simple. I'm not really sure how I want to go about. You know what? See, and then you end up getting a bright idea. So I actually have a bright idea. No. I'm gonna leave it like that. I like that. Okay. Let's rename that center pocket 0.25. Okay, that's it, guys. I mean, I just designed my whole entire game board. It's not super difficult. Now I need to go about saving all these tool paths. We've done that in a million other videos, so I'm not going to bore you with that here. It's been long enough. Let's take a look at this one more time. Let's see, take a peek. And there you have it. That's going to be our game board. So what we'll do is hopefully tomorrow we'll get this out in the garage and we'll cut it. We'll paint it. And then, you know, we'll get the frame made for it and everything else. But, yeah, that's it. Not too hard. And we'll get the rest of it done tomorrow, hopefully. So that's how I went about designing this. And, you know, thanks for watching the design video if you managed to make it through the whole thing. But, yeah, we'll get out there and finish it up tomorrow. So stay tuned and hopefully we'll be able to get out and do it.